Hey guys, my name is Olga and I'm happy to see you here in this new video. And today we are gonna try new limited edition from Catrice, Arctic Illusion. We are gonna try almost all products from this collection with one single exception. I decided not buying this brush just simply because it's not new to Catrice actually. And if you tend to buy limited brushes, you know what to expect actually. So let's start. And now our first product for today is gonna be face glaze. And I'm impressed based on swatches, but I don't have a single clue how this product will behave on face. I just simply hope, crossing fingers, that it won't dissolve my foundation because I wanna apply it on face and I wanna apply it on eyelid. So let's start. And by the way, yes, we have one more highlighter to try, but we should try this one as well. So it's liquid, it's gel based. Oh, it's so beautiful, I like it. So please be careful. And I don't know. Okay, I will try to apply it with a brush. So grabbing a little bit, taking off extra just in case, and starting from this side. Ooh, curls. Let's add a bit more. Please don't dissolve. Let me show it to you slightly differently. So less lightening. And let's add a little bit more. It's great. Perfect. First of all, it didn't dissolve my foundation. It looks wonderful and it shifts from pink to blue with a bit of purple. Let's apply it on eyelid. Grabbing it on a small brush. I have a bit of concealer here. Yep. I mean, it's great. It dries just in case. So you can keep it as it is. And let's blend the edge right here a bit. Of course, it doesn't have visible base, but we have nice shimmers here. And yeah, I will probably layer it a bit and gonna wait till it dries. Actually, it may dissolve a foundation, especially if you're gonna kind of drag it. If you just simply pat it on skin, it should be fine. But if you first of all apply a lot, so if you're gonna grab a lot and if you're gonna drag it, you may take off for your foundation easily by doing this. If you're gonna pat, everything should be fine. The only thing that on eyelid, I think it may crease. And it started to crease actually a bit, but I will probably layer. We'll try to layer it a bit. Now we're gonna try the second highlighter. It reminds me slightly Fenty Beauty again, but we'll see. I think it's a little bit clear, I mean the texture. So let's take a look. Yep. But it's not that glittery. And the size of glitters, I would say, is quite small. If we compare it to Essence, Essence is slightly different. And I think that this highlighter has slightly visible base. So it's cold and no, it's not really due to Fenty, because this particular highlighter definitely has it. It's not that super visible, but still it's visible. Let's do an eye look together quickly. I'm gonna use a bronzer as a crease shade and let's go. And of course I'm gonna layer this beautiful product. At least I will try. And as well in the center I want to add this beautiful highlighter a bit. or maybe not a bit. Let's layer, as usual, starting from the center. And probably I will keep it like this. And let's add a little bit more here, just in case. If you want to see the color, suggest looking down and wait till the product is fully dried. We can move on, but I can definitely feel this product. You feel like you have something on eyelid, and it's a little bit heavy actually. So if you want to add a thin layer, it's not going to be that glittery. But if you're going to layer it, you're going to feel it. So that's life. Let's add a bit of this highlighter in the inner corner and probably on the lower lid as well. I'm gonna be a frozen queen today because we have some glitters for the brows as well. I haven't applied it yet, but I will do. We should try it. And as well, I want to add it as a mascara. So I'm gonna use a basic one and gonna add the other one over. Now, black eyeliner, gonna add it near the lash line. And of course, I'm gonna draw a wing. In the waterline, I'm gonna add an eyeliner from Eveline, shade silver. And I'm gonna draw quite a long wing today. I like this look and I wish I could keep it, but we have to try this strange thing. Actually, it's a glitter brow styler. I won't keep it on brows till the end of the day, okay? Because I'm not gonna wear it. I don't wanna wear it the whole day, but let's add a bit. Yes, it's glittery, it's silver. How am I gonna remove it without ruining my makeup? I don't know. And I do wanna add glitters here. A beautiful glittery mascara. A topper. Reminds me a product from Revolution. The review is going to be published on Sunday. I think it's going to be far better if you wear it on lashes. It looks funny. Okay, anyway. I don't have a single clue how I will remove it. Santa Claus. Okay. But it looks funny and it's visible. And our final product for today, lip glosses. I took all shades, so I'm gonna show them to you. We are gonna start from the first shade. And we have beautiful pink and golden glitters here. And this product, this texture, this formula contains menthol. So it's more like a plumper. And it reminds me an existing formula from Catrice. Shade 1, as you can see, fully transparent, glitters are visible, feels comfortable on lips, it's not sticky. And you can feel a little bit the glitters on lips, but not that badly, so it's not that sandy. Shade 2 is colder. Contains dark blue and a bit of purple glitters. And shade 3 is more on pink side. It mainly contains pink and purple glitters. And of course, it's fully transparent, despite the fact that in the packaging, for instance, the second shade appears more blue. The third shade appears more pink. By the way, it contains as well golden glitters, but not that many if we compare them to pink glitters. I like all shades and I like this formula, and no, it's not new to Catrice, and we are gonna talk about that quite soon. Now I'm gonna show you makeup look closely and we are gonna discuss. I can't really tell you that I'm super happy with my current look, just simply because of the brows. I'm happy with the highlighters, with my eye makeup, but I'm not happy with the brows. They look way too strange, way too gray. But anyway, I will keep this product as it is and we'll wear it the whole day. Oh yeah. Okay, let me tell you what I'm wearing currently on lips as a lip liner. Catrice in shade 150. And I've mixed these two shades and applied this beautiful lip gloss. Well, lip glosses, actually, on lips. And I do like this combo, and actually, I do like this formula. We are gonna start from the lip glosses. Okay, I took all three shades and I'm quite happy with all of them. They are great. This formula is not new to Catrice, guys. It's not new to Catrice. And if you have this lip gloss from Catrice, you know what you should expect. It's called Maxed It Up. I have this product in two shades, if I'm not mistaken, 30 and 50. It's the same formula. It's comfortable to wear it. It doesn't dissolve products before, and it's quite comfortable to wear it. It's not sticky at all. And these three shades, I think they're new, and we are gonna do some swatches. By the way, this formula contains menthol, so it is a plumper. And if you don't like menthol, you definitely wouldn't like this product. So let me do some swatches. I think that this shade is quite similar to this one, shade 50, but it's not exactly the same, I would say. Here we have a bit more something green. Here we have a little bit less. But anyway, let's start. Shade 60 contains... Oh, not 60, 30. Shade 30 contains mainly blue glitters and a bit of purple. Shade 50 is a beautiful duochrome. It shifts from pink to golden. Looks lovely on lips. And we are gonna start from the first shade. Yeah, it looks quite similar to shade 50. And actually, they look almost the same. So if you have shade 50, I don't really think that you should buy shade 1 from the limited edition, because really they look way too similar. A mix of pink, purple and golden shimmers. Dupe. Shade 2. It appears quite similar to shade 30, but shade 30 contains more blue shimmers. Shade 2 contains dark blue with a bit of purple shimmers, so they are not exactly the same. So this shade is a new one. And shade 3 contains mainly pink shimmers. Wow, so shimmery. Looks lovely. Ah, I like this product and I like this formula. It's way too great. So, if you have tried this formula from Catrice, you know what you should expect. And I think it is a nice formula to try if you have never tried it. And let's talk about this lovely product, Glitter Brow Styler. It's more like a topper. You can use this product as a mascara, as a topper mascara, or you can apply it on your brows. But I don't really suggest doing it unless you're gonna do a creative look. For daily looks, I don't think it is a great idea, actually, because it looks a little bit strange and your brows appear more gray. Not from the good side, actually. And, well, seems a little bit strange, actually. But if you apply it as a topper on your lashes, it looks funny and it makes sense. If we compare this product to Revolution Pro, I think that Catrice is better. It's more pigmented and it's more glittery, actually. And we have, and by the way, it separates lashes at the same time, because the product from Revolution does really nothing. It's glittery, yeah, but it sticks a bit the lashes together, and it does, well, it gives a bit of glitters, and that's it. And actually they look differently. I would say that this product has color. The product from Revolution doesn't really have it, and it's a clear gel with glitters, I would say. So if you need, why not? If you don't need, well, probably you don't need it. Moving to the highlighters, and I'm gonna start from this beautiful jelly highlighter. I don't like it, and I don't like the way this product looks on eyelid. It looks so beautiful, and it's a duochrome. This product shifts from blue to purple and a bit to pink. I've been wearing my makeup actually around 2 hours already, and for now everything looks quite great, especially on eyelid. I thought that this product would crease, but it didn't. It didn't crease, at least for now. We will see how it goes and we will check it out, but for now, it seems fine. This product doesn't dissolve a foundation, and I'm surprised because I thought that it could happen, but no, it behaves normally, especially if you apply appropriate amount of a product. If you apply a lot, well, in this case it may dissolve a foundation, and especially if you use such foundations, be careful with them. And but if you use a foundation like this, which is more creamy, which is slightly thicker, it should be fine. It should be fine. And this shift from pink to purple and blue, It's visible. It's really, really visible and looks interesting. So I do like it. And this product appears more glittery on eyelid, and it doesn't really have visible base. But of course, if you layer, if you apply a lot, you'll be able to see something. It's going to be more like something, I would say, pink. Light pink, but it's not that super visible. And if you apply this product on eyelid, at the beginning you can really feel it. You feel something on your eyelid, and it's a little bit it's not that thin, I would say, and that's why you can feel it. But within, let's say, an hour, no, you just simply don't pay attention to it, and it seems okay. And if you want to apply it on eyelid, apply it and wait till the product is fully dried. So look down and wait. Otherwise, this product may easily crease. I like it. I think it's great. I think it's gorgeous. And please, please don't remove this part, because otherwise this product will definitely dry out, and you won't be able to do anything with it. I like it, and especially I do like this particular shade. It looks so beautiful and great. And our last product for today, it looks gorgeous. I do like this packaging. Just take a look. The quality is amazing, and I'm impressed. And if we talk about this collection and the packagings from this collection, they're great. I like this story. I like that all these packagings are slightly, I would say, frozen. We have some crystals here, and these crystals, they remind me ice. So it's a kind of icy collection, frozen collection. So yeah, I'm impressed, and yes, I like it. Yes, I like it. And I think that this collection is one of the best, especially if we compare it to the latest releases from Essence, for instance. And yeah, great, great, stunning. Okay, the product inside. Actually, it's quite nice, but if you thought that it looks like Fenty Beauty. Not really, guys. It is a basic highlighter, which is slightly glittery, and it has visible base. And yes, of course, you can try to apply it as glittery highlighter, but it won't be that easy. You can, for instance, apply it and blend it, and in this case, it would appear similar to Fenty, but not exactly the same. I think that this highlighter from Essence is closer to Fenty than this highlighter. If you have gold undertone, it is a beautiful, beautiful choice, and especially if you have pale skin. If you have extremely pale skin, it's your choice, and it's going to be the best highlighter in your case. Because, well, it's frosty, really frosty, white with silver. And even if you have warm undertone, you can apply it correctly. Forget about that. Don't apply a lot. And in this case, this base is not going to be visible. Blend this highlighter, and in this case, it's not going to be visible that this product has slightly visible and even gray, silver gray base. And in this case, even if you have medium skin tone, it's possible to apply this highlighter and it would look normally. But of course, if you kind of take a lot and apply a lot, in case of medium skin tone or in case of warm undertone, it might be visible. But if you have pale skin, it's the best choice in your case. And of course, let's do some swatches. I wanted to say, never mind. So we're going to start from Catrice. And as you can see, this highlighter is quite bright. By the way, it doesn't really emphasize skin texture unless you apply a lot. Then let's apply, of course, Fenty Beauty. And Fenty is more glittery and doesn't have visible base. So you see, they are way too different. The next one is going to be Essence. My heart beats. Tisca, let's apply it as well. Same thing. It's closer to Fenty. As you can see, no visible base, just simply glitters. Eveline Varieté Shade 2, beautiful highlighter, like it. And they have this highlighter in two shades, but this formula, I mean, two shades are available, but they have different formulas. Same, glittery, basic highlighter, glitters. As well, by the way, I think that this highlighter from Ingrid Cosmetics, Team X, is closer to Catrice. And let's try to do like this. Yep. So these two, they are quite similar. And the last highlighter I wanted to show you from Rival, Essentials Collection. Ta-da-da-dum. As you can see, this highlighter is not a dupe to Fenty Beauty, but yes, it's possible to apply it as extra, as additional glitters, but it's not going to be that easy. If you want to try, or if you want to save a little bit of your money and try something similar, something familiar to Essence or Eveline, why not? And it was our, oh, by the way, I forgot, I have one more similar product from Makeup by Maria, and I think it's the closest product to Fenty Beauty. Now you know. And it was our last product for today, so let's quickly check out how all products behave. I have my makeup on around 10 hours, and we are gonna check everything out. We are gonna start from this beautiful highlighter. Of course, it creased. It's expected. Yeah, actually, it's expected. Look at this. Look at this mascara, brow mascara. Oh gosh, yeah, it's long lasting. I don't have any questions. Quite pity, but okay. Highlighters right here look wonderful, both of them. So let me know down below what you think about this collection from Catrice. Do you like it or not? And are you gonna buy any products from this collection or no? I hope you enjoyed this video, and if yes, don't forget to put a thumbs up and of course consider subscribing if you haven't subscribed yet. I wish you a pleasant day and I hope to see you soon in the next video. Bye bye!